At the end of this online module, you should be able to manually compute and present in equation form the coefficients of a best fit linear model using least squares method, manually compute the SSE, manually compute the SST, manually compute the R squared value, interpret the slope and intercept of a best fit linear model, interpret the R squared value, and use the best fit linear model to make predictions only when appropriate. Let's consider a problem that will help us learn about how to calculate least squares linear regression and to verify how well it models the line. An engineer working within the personal computer industry wants to understand the changes in the percentage of households in the United States that own a personal computer. Using data obtained from the U.S. Census Bureau, the engineer has been tasked with modeling the change over time and verifying the quality of the model. To calculate least squares regression manually, the first thing that needs to be done is to plot the data. The data are plotted here in Excel. The graph represents how the percentage of U.S. households with a computer increased from 1984 to 2015. Note that time is commonly the independent variable because we can't control it. The data appear roughly linear, so we will use least squares regression to create a linear model of the relationship between time and years and percent of U.S. households with a computer. We can do this by creating a table with all of the variables and calculations from the least squares regressions equations shown here. There is another online module that describes these equations in detail. For simplicity's sake and to save space, I'm going to use the variable x for the time and y for the households in all calculations shown in the module. Then we will return to the descriptive variables when presenting the results. Let's begin making our table considering the formulas for least squares regression and the data that were given in the problem statement. Before we begin, note that I have used rounded values throughout this module. However, all calculations use the non-rounded values. First thing I'm going to do is write the slope equation with all the blanks I need to fill. I see I need the mean of the x's, the mean of the y's, the mean of the product of x and y, and the mean of x squared. So I will add a mean line to the bottom of my table and take the mean of both the x's and the y's. I can fill these in my equation, so the 2001 goes here and here, and the 49.7 goes here. Next, I need the mean of the product of x and y, so I will add a column to my table that calculates the product of each x and y. Looking at the first data point, I take 2015 times 79 to get 159,185. I can repeat this process for all other points. Then take the mean of the column to get 99,589. And that goes here in my equation. Finally, I need to calculate all of the x squareds, so I'll make a column for these. If I calculate the first point, I see that 2015 squared is 4,060,225. Okay, so I can repeat the squaring for all the rest of the data points. Now I need to take the mean of this column and I get 4,003,694. That value goes here. So now I just calculate this expression and get that the slope is equal to 2.6. Looking at the y-intercept equation, I see that I need the mean of the y's, the a value, and the mean of the x's. I already have all of these, so I will plug in that b equals 49.7 minus 2.6 times 2001. That gives me negative 5,203. Notice that our y-intercept value is negative 5,203. Remember that this is in percentage of households, so this has no meaning. It literally means the percentage of U.S. households owning a computer more than 2,000 years ago, long before the invention of the computer, and before the U.S. was a country. This is another reminder that in spite of how clearly linear this model is during the period from 1984 to 2015, there is no guarantee that the relationship stays linear outside that range. Now we plug in the values of the slope and the y-intercept into the equation of the line to get the equation of our modeled line, which gives households equals 2.6 times time minus 5,203. This linear model describes the data for years 1984 through 2015. It indicates that the rate of U.S. households that own a computer is increasing by 2.6% per year. And it has an intercept that is required for the model but does not have meaning for the actual data because year equals zero is outside the data range and does not make sense in this context. Next, we need to see how well our model fits our data. Here is the model we just found. In order to figure out how well our model fits the data, we will use sum of squared errors and total sum of squares to calculate the coefficient of determination, R squared. There is another online module that describes these measures in detail. The coefficient of determination is the measure that relates these and is our best measure of goodness of fit for the model. That equation is r squared equals 1 minus SSE divided by SST. As a reminder, r squared is a measure of the percent of the variability in the data that can be explained by the model, and the closer this measure is to 1 or 100%, the better the fit of our linear model. So now we need to calculate SSE and SST in order to calculate r squared. The equation to calculate SSE is the sum of the squared differences of all the actual data points y sub I and the modeled points f of x sub I. Let's apply this to our example. We will do this by using a tabular approach. As before, I will use unrounded values in my calculations, then round to a reasonable precision to display answers. I will begin using all of my actual data points. Notice that I have labeled these x sub I and y sub I. Again, that means they are the real data points. Looking at the equation for SSE, I can see that I need y sub I, which I already have in the table, and I also need the f of x sub I, which are the modeled y values. I will create a column for the f of x sub I's and calculate each of them. The f of x sub I takes 2015 and plugs it in for our x in the modeled line, multiplies that by the slope, 2.6, and subtracts 5,203, giving me 86.7. I repeat this for all other x sub i's. Now let's do the subtraction part of the SSE equation. For the first line, we take 79 minus 86.7 to get negative 7.7. Again, repeat this for all x sub i's. Now we need to square each of the differences. So for the first line, that means squaring the negative 7.7, giving me 58.7. And again, we repeat this for all x sub i's. Finally, I need to sum all of the squares of the errors. This gives me 207.4, and this number is the SSE value, and completes this calculation. Calculating SST is similar to calculating SSE. Looking at the equation for SST, we will also calculate this using a table, and x sub I and y sub I are the actual data points. First, we need to calculate y sub I minus y bar. And remember that y bar is the average of all the y sub I values, which we calculated earlier to be 49.7% of U.S. households. So for the first value in the table, we take 79 minus 49.7 to get 29.4. I repeat subtracting 49.7 for all other y i's. Now I need to square the difference terms. So I will square the 29.4 to get 861.4. And repeat squaring for all the other difference terms. Finally, I need to sum all of the squares of the deviations. This gives me 6,622.6, and this number is the SST value and completes this calculation. Finally, we need to use the values we calculated for SSE and SST to determine our r squared value. Remember that the equation for r squared is 1 minus SSE divided by SST. So plug in the values from the last two slides, getting 1 minus 207.4 divided by 6,622.6, which gives 0.969. This is very close to 1. So that tells us that this line models our data very well. Specifically, this means our model explains 96.9% of the variation in the data. In summary, this online module provided examples of calculating the parts of the least squares regression equations to find the slope and y-intercept of a best fit line. It also showed how to calculate each of the SSE, SST, and r squared values for a regression line, and it helped us learn to interpret the slope and intercept of a best fit linear model and the resulting r squared value.